Battleship Island Singapore Press Conference， 各位朋友上午好，欢迎大家来到韩国电影军舰岛的记者会，我是丽仪。My name is Lee and I'll be your MC for this afternoon. And today I guess all of us here were gathered and we are really really excited because we have the three main male leads from the movie joining us today as well as the director himself. 那今天我想大家在现场应该都是还蛮兴奋的，但是看到大家其实都很矜持的坐着。不用矜持了，可以放松一下，可以放松一下，表情不用这么紧绷，如果想尖叫的话尖叫，OK 的，要先叫一下吗？
不理。
Thank you. The single person for me and the rest for, you know, our actors and our director, of course. And today we have our actors, veteran actor, also award-winning Mr. Hong Jong-min, as well as very versatile, reputable actor Mr. Song Chi-sok, and...The Hedgehog, the most popular Mr. Song Joong-ki, as well as director award-winning Mr. Liu Seung-wan joining us today here at the Battleship Island Singapore Press Conference. This movie actually is quite a dark movie. It's set in World War II and depicts the life of Korean laborers who were forced to work under extremely harsh conditions. That actually sets as a backdrop for their dramatic escape towards the end of the movie.那其实这部电影呢，跟大家报告一下，在韩国7月26号上映的时候呢，就已经是呢突破了在韩国的票房记录，因为入场观赏电影的人次呢，就已经是超过100万。那今天在现场呢，除了很热闹，看到很多熟悉的媒体朋友之外呢，我们在官方的平台上面也有 Facebook Live， 所以让无法来到现场的朋友呢，也可以透过 Facebook Live 呢，现场的感受到我们这边的这个热闹的氛围的。And this is the first time the Battleship Island is actually promoting outside of Korea. So I guess Singapore, all of us are really lucky to be the first stop for the overseas movie promotion for the Battleship Island. And besides the press conference today, the director and cast will be meeting the fans at the one and only public appearance, which is the meet and greet event later on at Suntec City, and also the gala premiere at Sands Theatre tonight, and that will conclude the promotional tour here in Singapore. Well, this entire star tour would not have been possible without a lot of partners and friends, so I would like to thank them. The entire Battleship Island star tour is proudly presented by TVN Movies, official pay TV channel Hub eCity, and also supporting TV partner TVN.The movie is co-distributed by Global Films and Golden Village Pictures in association with King Kong Media Productions, the number 8 yard in Singapore. The movie sneaks from 11 to 13 of August and opens on the 17th of August in Singapore. Once again, a very gentle reminder to all our media friends, later during the press conference, please kindly remain in your seats. Do not move around in the room, in the function room,because we will be arranging for a photo opportunity to capture both individual and group photos of the cast and director during the designated photography session at the end of the press conference. 那再一次的温馨提醒就是呢，在整个记者会进行的当然呢，请所有的媒体朋友们呢继续的留在座位，不要站起来，也不要四处的走动，因为在记者会结束之前呢，将会安排这个机会让大家可以拍照。会安排演员就是个别的上台，还有呢这个团体的照片的这个拍摄的机会，所以呢大家可以继续的留在座位上，谢谢大家的配合。And before we welcome our actors, before I get all of you go screaming, will you? Yes, no? All right, before we welcome the actors and directors on stage, let us invite our co-distributor of the Battleship Island in Singapore, the boss himself, Mr. Lim Chik.Managing Director of Global Films to say a few words. Yes. We'd like to thank Mr. Lim Tae for making the star tour happen.
Thank you. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. We, on behalf of my co-distributors, Golden Village and Nikon Media and another India, we welcome you to the press conference for the Battleship Island.We are really, really honored to be able to invite the artist and the director himself to Singapore for this promotion. And I think YMP and Howard and the team for arranging for the star tour, as well as the three management companies for making sure that artists are here in Singapore. Thank you so much. Also, I'd like to thank our presenting sponsor, TVN Movies. Thank you for supporting this movie, and it's been a few months collaborating and supporting Korean movies in Singapore. So thank you so much, TVN, and as well as Michelle Moore, Suntec, and also Starhub, our regular partners. Then also, I'd like to thank my entire team, because everyone has worked really hard to make this Star Tour happen. My team has averaged work up to 12 midnight every night. It's been really, really tough, and I'm so glad we pulled this off. Last, I'd like to thank the director for coming to Singapore. I know many, many female fans here. Many females here are actually fans of Mr. Song Joong-ki and Mr. Soo Ji-sup. But personally, I'm a bigger fan of Mr. Wong Joon-min. Yeah, he's really the top actor, and I'm so honored to have all three of them as the director here in Singapore. Thank you.
So thank you a lot, because I know a lot of our media fans here are also big fans of Mr. Wong Joon-min. Yes, I see nods from our media friends. 可能想请问一下老板。
那老板其实之前呢也带过很多韩国电影进新加坡嘛，当中就包括非常受欢迎的《釜山行》。那对这一次军舰岛这部电影，老板有什么样的期许吗？其实我们在新加坡是叫十三列车，然后当然很幸运有带过很多不同的成功的韩国电影到新加坡。不过这一次，真的没想到能够把这整个军舰岛的艺人跟导演带来新加坡，还要真的要谢谢一个很重要的伙伴，就是我们的 Marina Bay Sands。 I mean, we are really, really happy here at this beautiful location. And I think 这个东西我们真的集合了很多方面的支持才做得到。所以我们也对这部电影的期待非常非常大。我们希望可以在新马两地都做得到。
Well, I think definitely with the support from all our media friends and our fans, a big hand from Mr. Lin Tae. Yes, we worked very hard, sir. Because I saw him posted on social media this morning at like 1 a.m. So he has been working very hard himself. And now the moment all of you have been waiting for, 不要再矜持了，各位媒体朋友。 Okay, please, the biggest round of applause for our cast, main cast and director of the Battleship Island. Please put your hands together to welcome director Mr. Liu Seung-wan. And also Mr. Hong Kong-min.
UNESCO 세계문화유산으로 등재하는 추진 움직임이 있을 때 the making of this film all began with a picture, particular picture of the Battleship Island that he saw back in 2013. It was so overwhelming, and the image was so powerful that, and when he found out the historical account behind, the background behind the island, he was really moved to bring the story to the audience, to the public. So, yes, definitely there are a lot of challenges along the way, the journey, but when you think about the suffering and the atrocities that took place within the island, the challenge they went through is actually nothing to that.
Well, actually, this part of history has actually came alive on the big screen because of the acting of our wonderful actors. And Mr. Hong Jong-min for himself is actually not the first time working with our director. So how did he feel working with the director?
황정민 씨 같은 경우에는 류 감독님이랑 작품을 하신 게 첫 번째가 아니시잖아요. 다시 이렇게 같이 작업을 하게 되신 사람이 어떠신지?
다시 작품을 하게 돼서 일단은 다시 시켜줘서 고맙고요. 웬만하면 잘 안 시켜주는데 한 번 끝나고 다시 시켜줘서 고맙고 그리고 무상도라는 영화 작업에 제가 참여할 수 있는 어떤 계기만으로도 저한테 제 필모에서 되게 큰 영광이었습니다.
Well, first of all, director Yu doesn't recast a lot of actors in his new movie, so he's extremely blessed and very, very thankful that he has casted him in his new latest film. I'm really honored to be able to tell this part of his history to the public.
And beside Mr. Hong Jong-min, we have Mr. So Ji-seop, a very charismatic actor. And in the movie, he actually played the role of a gangster with a lot of action scenes. So I'm just wondering, you know, did he actually got injured?
So Ji-seop 씨는 평소에도 굉장히 카리스마 넘치는 배우로 유명하신데 이번 영화에서도 굉장히 감동 높은 액션 씬이 많았잖아요. 혹시 중간에 부상은 없으셨는지?
특별히 큰 부상은 없었고요. 자잘한 상황상으로 있었는데 촬영을 전에 한 달 반 정도 연습을 하고 들어가서 막상 촬영할 때는 큰 부상 없이 촬영을 잘 마쳤습니다.
There was a lot of preparation put into filming those action scenes. And in fact, he took about 1.5 months preparing really to every detail of every scene. So there wasn't any major injuries during the filming.
Well, thank goodness for that. And another question for the director. This movie actually is a rather heavy genre to begin with. So how is it like at the filming set? Who is the happy pill in the filming set that actually encourages everybody on?
영화의 소재가 다소 좀 무거울 수 있는 그런 스토리인데 그 세트상에서 뭔가 해피 바이러스 같은 존재가 있었다면 누가 있었을까요?
Would you like to vote?
저는 그 토이로 나온 수환 씨가 아이언맨 친구인데 그 친구가 현장에 나오면 그거 말씀하신 대로 해피 바이러스 때문에 모든 사람들이 웃게 만드는 팀이 있더라고요. 그래서 너무 좋았어요.
So the happy pill on set was Kim Soo-hun, who played So-hee in the movie. So as a child actress, she has a very bright character, very cheerful. So whenever she appears on the set, she makes everyone laugh.
And of course, Mr. Hong Jong-min played the role of a father in the movie. So in the movie, we actually saw Mr. Hong Jong-min, he's really a man of many talents because he plays the clarinet, he dances, he sings, and he spoke really good Japanese. So, how has he prepared for the character in the movie?
황정민 씨 같은 경우는 영화에서 굉장히 많은 것을 보여주셨는데, 뭐 클라리넷을 연주하신다든지 아니면 그리고 또 일본어도 구사를 하셨고요. 어떻게 이런 것들을 준비를 하셨어요?
클라리넷은 제가 취미로 하고 있는 악기고요. 그래서 뭐 그렇게 어렵지는 않고. 일본말 같은 경우는 저는 제가 일본말을 못하는 사람이라 일단 무조건 배웠어요. 아무 생각 없이 배웠어요. 그래서 그랬는데 좀 어려웠고 네, 그렇게 준비했습니다. 일단 무조건 배웠어요.
question. So all the Japanese lines that he spoke in the movie, he memorized them all.
My God, 정말 대단해요. Okay, yeah, so well, really impressive that he actually memorized it without knowing the language. And for Mr. Song Joong-hee, in the movie, he actually plays the role of a soldier again. So how did it feel like? Because in the drama, Descendants of the Sun, it was so, you know, well loved by fans all over the world, and this the same role as a soldier again in the movie. So how did you feel about that?
홍준표 씨 같은 경우에는 그 드라마 태양의후예에서 군인 역할로 굉장히 많은 사랑을 받으셨잖아요. 근데 이번 군함도에서도 또 군인의 모습을 보여주셨는데 어떠셨어요?
film that scene. And because it was actually the very first real action scene in the movie, so a lot of emphasis was placed into reenacting the real fight, the scene inside the movie. So he spent a lot of time together with the director preparing for this scene.
So were there a lot of NGs in the course of filming?
그럼 중간에 NG가 혹시 많았는지?
아, 특별히 NG가 났던 건 없는 것 같아요.
I'm not in any particular.
Wow, really? That's, well, you know, a great actor is always well prepared, and actually we saw from some of the clips, the making of, that he actually memorized all the action sequence yeah, before filming. Yeah, so that's really very, very professional. And Mr. Hwang Jung-min, actually in the movie, he's very experienced. You know? The fact that he took up this project, would he say that, you know, this movie is the toughest for him so far?
황정민 씨 같은 경우는 지금까지 굉장히 다양한 역할을 해오셨잖아요. 근데 군함도 그 기존에 연기하셨던 작품들과 비교했을 때 지금 이 군함도라는 작품이 연기하기에 특별히 더 힘든 점이 있으셨나요?
그렇죠. 뭐 다른 작업에 대해서는 굉장히 힘든 부분이 있었어요. 그러니까 어쨌든 공간이 주는 그 군함도라는 그 공간이 주는 어떤 척박한 그 안에서 인간 분장이 살아나가 어떻게 하면은 그 삶을 잘 살아나가야 되는가라는 것이 많았고 그 다음에 저만 살아가야 되는 게 아니라 제 딸 아이가 있잖아요. 근데 그 딸 아이가 어떻게 상황에 처해져 있는 것도 제가 너무 잘 알고 있으니까 그 아이를 어떻게 보살피면서 특히나 이 아이가 이 말도 안 되는 장소에서 숨 쉬고 살아나갈 수 있게끔 해주는 겁니다. 그러니까 저는 두 가지 어쨌든 고민을 했던 거죠. 또 하나는 아무튼 그렇습니다. 네. 짧게 짧게 해야지 길게 시간이.
So two things, two concerns as he filmed this movie. The first was about there was a sense of fear because the set was so real and so massive, and it really reenacted the Battleship Island many years ago. So there was the sense of fear that, which was very overwhelming, that he got when he first set foot onto the set. And also the story is about survival, about surviving and escaping from the island as a captive laborer. And inside the movie, he plays a role as a father of a daughter. So he has a young daughter to protect and to escape together with. At the same time, he has to make sure she's well and she's well taken care of. So there are a lot of deep thoughts that were placed into this movie in these two aspects.
And a question for the director. Actually, I'm very curious, the last scene of the movie is actually on So-hee. The last scene is a close-up of her looking afar. Yeah, so I'm just wondering why, you know, is that arrangement, why that arrangement has been made, you know, to end the movie in that way?
영화의 엔딩이 소희 양의 김소연 양의 얼굴 포석으로 끝나거든요. 그 엔딩이 준 어떤 그런 메시지라든지 상징이 있나요?
이 영화를 보시게 되면 그 지금 질문하신 사회적으로서 말씀하신 그 마지막 장면에 스포일러가 되어 다 밝히지 못하지만 이 조선인들이 탈출에 성공하고 나서 굉장히 큰 현대사의 전환점을 목격하게 되는 장면이 있습니다. 그 장면이 앞서까지 컬러 화면으로 진행되다가 흑백으로 바뀌어요. 그러니까 마치 이 모든 것이 과거의 역사인 것처럼 변하지만 우리는 그것이 과거라고 생각을 하지만 그것을 목격하는 사람이 앞으로 살 날이 더 많은 그러니까 미래를 미래가 더 중요한 한 소녀가 그 모습을 바라보고 있는 얼굴로 바뀌고 싶었습니다. 그리고 그 소녀의 눈동자가 관객들과 마주치게 해주셨어요. 그 소녀의 모습은 지금 영화를 보고 있는 우리가 된 것일지도 모르기 때문에 그래서 이 영화가 그저 과거의 소재를 다룬 것이 아니라 여전히 현재형인 현재형인 역사의 문제라고 생각했습니다. 그래서 그 소녀의 얼굴
I cannot reveal too many as it will be a spoiler for all here, but one of the main So the little girl who then went through the atrocities that happened took place in the island and who survived and escaped the island eventually, she signifies our history, our past. At the same time, she also directs us to our future. So she also exemplifies the future of us. And you know, as she stares into the audience, into the camera, I really wanted to her eyes to meet the audiences, because I felt that I wanted the audience to feel, as you know, to be placed in a situation where put yourself into the shoes of the character, and from the past, by looking back in the past, you know, think of where you should be going in the future.
Well, I think it's a very meaningful way to end the movie, and I'm sure a lot of you are looking forward to catch the movie, those who have the tickets to the gala premiere tonight. One question for all our lead actors as well as the director. Can they describe what is the most memorable scene to them for the movie?
배우분과 감독님 각각 가장 기억에 남는 신에 대해서 말씀해 주시죠.
가장 기억에 남는 장면은 뭐 각자 다르겠지만 저는 아무래도 저희 다 이제 이게 스포일러가 될 거 말씀 못 드리겠지만 탈출하는 장면이 가장 관건이었고 정말 또 많은 거기에 슬픈 장면이기도 하고 여러 가지로 저는 탈출 신이 그냥 기억이 나는 것 같아요.
So for me, it will be the mass escape sequence towards the end of the movie, because not just because of the flawless image or the cinematography, but also because of the sadness, and it really depicts the suffering and a lot of hardship that the neighbors, captive neighbors, went through in the island.
저는 이 영화를 만든 감독으로서 이 영화를 보신 관객분들, 앞으로 보실 관객분들이 가장 기억에 남는 장면이 바로 제가 가장 좋아하는 장면입니다.
My favorite scene would be very much aligned with your favorite scene. I cannot pick just one, so whatever. After every audience watches the movie, if you have, I'm sure you will have your own favorite scene from the movie, so that will be my favorite scene as well.
Well, I'm sure the director is looking forward as well to hear feedback from the overseas fans. Yeah, can we hear from Mr. Hong Jong-min, please?
저는 영화에서 제일 좋아하는 이제 컷으로 따지면 마지막 성인 얼굴로 끝나잖아요. 그걸 가장 좋아하는데 이유가 그 얼굴에 그 아픔과 슬픔과 희망과 그리고 과거와 현재의 미래가 다 있는.
be the ending where it zooms into the camera, zooms into the character Sohee, because I feel that that face, that particular expression on the little girl's face, really expresses the pain, the suffering she went through, hardships, as well as hope, and also the past and the present.
One last question from me before we open up to the floor. Okay, the last question. Since the movie is about escaping from the Battleship Island amongst the three of you, just curious, or the four of you, yeah, who has the best survival skills?
네, 그 이 영화의 어떤 테마 중에 하나가 서바이벌 생존이잖아요. 근데 이 네 분 중에서 가장 생존 본능이 강한 분, 아니면 서바이벌 스킬이 강하신 분을 꼽자면 어떤 분이실까요?
아무래도 제일 나이가 어린 준기 씨가 아닌가. 군대에 갔던 것 같아요.
제가 제일 젊어서 네. 어떻게든 살아남을 구하는 정신을 제가 제일 네, 큰 것 같아요.
저희는 좀 많이 움직여 아파요. 그래서 맞아요. 네.
제가 맞는 것 같습니다. 네.
어제 봤나요? So Mr. Sohee mentioned that he feels Song Joong-ki is the, probably the best, has the best survival skill, probably because he's the youngest, and it's not too far ago that he has served his national service, so I'm sure the skills and the memories of the trainings are still fresh in him. For Mr. Song Joong-ki, yeah, he agrees and he feels the same because he's the youngest. And Mr. Hong Joong-ki mentioned that for the rest of them, except Mr. Song Joong-ki, a big movement or a very aggressive movement can cause pain in them.
So it's best to stay mute. All right, thank you so much for answering my questions. And now it's over to our media friends. Now the time is open to our media friends here to ask questions. Yes, Tina.
It's a very difficult question indeed. You're asking me what stage I am right now in my life. Very hard to say. I think I can only answer that question after some time has passed as I look back into the role I played in this particular movie.
저는 개인적으로 저도 그 스테이지라고 말씀해 주시면 딱 정확하게 짓기는 굉장히 어렵지만 그냥 배우 송중기 그리고 젊은이 송중기라는 친구한테 봤을 때도 제가 평소 갖고 있는 생각과 현재 감독님께서 부담되어서 표현하시려고 했던 여러 가지 느낌들이 제가 평소 갖고 있는 생각과 잘 맞았던 시기였던 것 같아요. 제 나이도 그렇고 제가 병원에서 생각하는 것들이 그렇고 그런 스테이지였던 것 같아요. 저 개인적인 송중기라는 친구한테도 네.
Again, it's a very challenging question and I wouldn't be able to answer the question on part of the question on which stage I am at this point in my life, but if you're talking about just, you know, like talking from this aspect of the movie alone, then I would say that my values and my thoughts and were very aligned, very much aligned. So the values and my thoughts I had at this point in time when I was working on this movie was very aligned with the directors. So that was the reason why I decided to work on this film.
And Mr. Hwang Jong-min has been in very deep thoughts. Very challenging question indeed.
순간 지금 내가 어떤 사람이고 어떤 스테이지 있나라는 그 생각에 아 조금 뭔가 반성 같은 뭐 순간 약간 내 스스로가 조금 진폐해지는 듯한 느낌이 드는 건 왜일까라는 생각도 들고 하면서 막 복잡한 생각이 드는데요. 아 저는 어쨌든 배우고 직업이 그다음에 광대고 관객들한테 작품을 보여주고 그 작품을 가지고 관객들하고 소통하는 사람이니까 그게 어릴 때부터 지금까지 계속 작업을 해오면서 늘 그 하나 변함없는 어떤 그 관객을 위해서 이 작품을 선택합니다라고 늘 생각했던 네. 지금 그렇게 잘 해오고 있나라는 생각이 순간 들어서 좀 심오해진 얼굴 그리고 얼굴 좀 빨개가지고 늘 심하게 생각하시는데 아무튼 그렇습니다. 좀 더 배워서 잘 살아야겠다는 생각도 드네요. 아무튼 그렇습니다.
Well, I have naturally red face, so yes, some of you may feel that I was really deep in thought, but is that probably because of my natural face color? Well, it was a very challenging question. The reason why I say this is because it made me think back about my acting journey and really made me look back. And somehow, I don't know why, but for some reason, I'm feeling a little embarrassed and ashamed of my journey so far because it's a very complex feeling. Because as an actor, I'm also an entertainer. So I communicate with the audience through the roles I play, the characters I play, and through the movies and productions I work in. And I always try to choose works that I feel I like, and I think audience will find entertaining. But that particular question really made me pose another question to myself, questioning me whether I'm doing it right. But all these decisions that I've been making so far has been a right one.
So Tina, would you like a response from your director himself?
Yes, if you wish.
Again, it is hard to say at which stage of my life I'm at right now, but because I don't try to put too much meaning into all this. I really try to convey the message, diligently convey the message that I want to deliver through my words. And I'm really curious to find out what the response would be from Singapore. And based on the response and a lot of the diverse response that I gathered from both Korea and overseas, I will decide on my next work. So I'm also curious to find out what my next path would take.
All right, thank you for that question, Tina. Yes, Yelin.
to answer the second part of the question first, yes, of course, he would be honored if the three, the director and the two actors, co-actors here, can attend this wedding. He would definitely invite them. Working with Ms. Song Hye-kyo in the future works, that's something he has to give a little more thought because he feels that it will be challenging, you know, because work is work. So maybe a little tough to work on the same production.
Okay, thank you for the question, Yen-Li. And can we have another question? Hong Ho, I saw your hand raising just now. Yes?
기대고 싶은 약간 그런 게 있어요. 괜찮아.
그러니까 그런 근사함이 분명히 있어요. 그리고 종기는 가정교육을 참 잘 받았어요. 그러니까 이 형들 사이에 딱 중간에서 이 배려해야 한다고 하는 거예요.
그러니까 배려도 많고 네. 또 잘생겼고
그건 안 받았어요. 아무튼 네, 배려나
남자가 봤을 때 정말 배려했어요. 근데 여자가 봤을 때 얼마나 배려했어요.
한정민 씨의 대답부터 먼저 해드릴게요. So feel that for Soji Sub, his actual character is very solid, and yet he is very gentle. He has a gentle side to him. So that concrete, solid character about him makes him feel like he wants to rely on him, you know, as someone who's very responsible and reliable. Whereas for Mr. Song Joong-ki, feel that he's very considerate, and as he worked on the set with him, on the movie with him, felt that his parents have raised him really well, because he's really well-mannered and very considerate. For Mr. Song Joong-ki, he mentioned that he finds Mr. Song Joong-ki, one of the most charming facts about Mr. Song Joong-ki is probably his looks, which can charm both men and women.
그리고 황정민 선배님의
같은 경우는 뭐 연기는 저희가 한 이렇게 기억을 할 수가 없고요. 현장에서 사람으로서 뭔가 큰 사람들이고요. 배우나 그런 스태프들이나 이렇게 하는 거 보면 너무나 큰 사람들.
황정민, I felt that he exudes great leadership, and he is a very big person. So, in terms of both the personality and his capacity as a human and actor.
그리고 후배 배우 입장에서 황정민 선배님을 봤을 때는 당연히 지섭이 형 방금 연기적으로 저희가 뭐 어떻게 감히 말씀드릴 수가 없지만 후배 배우 입장에서 선배님의 현장에서 뭔가 슛 들어갔을 때, 연기하실 때 집중력만큼은 정말로 너무나 제 것으로 만들고 싶을 정도로 그 점은 후배 배우 입장에서 무조건 배워야 되는 부분이 아닐까 싶을 정도로 그 집중력은 정말 최고신 것 같아요.
For Mr. Hwang Jung-hyun, I felt that he has this immense level of concentration when he's working on when he's acting, so that's something he really felt as a junior actor. That's something he really want to learn going forward from Mr. Hwang Jung-hyun.
1,000 words, he show with action. So I really look up to him in that aspect. And going forward, as when I reach his age, I would aspire to be someone like that, someone with a very solid character.
Well, we thank you to our director and all our actors for their very honest sharing today at the press conference. I'm so sorry that due to the time constraint, we cannot answer every question. I'm so sorry. Yeah, I'm sure there'll be another opportunity. And before the end of the press conference, we will be doing a series of photo sessions as promised. So can we invite the lead actors and director to leave the stage for a while we prepare for the photo taking session?
이어서 기념 촬영하기 전에 배우분들
of hearts.
주문 받으시고요. 하트 한번 날려주세요.
수고하셨습니다. 감사합니다.